In this video, I'll show you two examples on how to describe transformations of a sinusoidal function in the form y is equal to a sine x minus c plus d. Now, this also works with cosine. Let's start with question one. They ask us to describe each transformation for the sinusoidal function, and in our case, f at x is equal to negative 4 sine x plus 180 minus 3. Our a value here is negative 4. And what this tells us is the following. If a is less than 0, you end up with a reflection across the x-axis. So the first thing that this tells us is a reflection across the x. In addition, this tells us that if a is less than negative 1, you end up with a vertical stretch. A vertical stretch will make the wave skinnier. In other words, it will take all the y-coordinates along the wave and make them bigger, which gives you the impression that the wave is getting skinnier. The next letter that we will define is c. Our c value here appears to be positive 180, but it's actually not. Take a look at the template. Notice that your template is x minus c, but our equation, it's x plus 180. So we have to model our equation to look like the template. Now, to make this plus into a minus, you have to add two negatives together. So you'd have x minus negative 180. This expression and this expression mean the exact same thing. Negative times a negative is a positive. So this tells us exactly what our c value is. Our c value is negative 180 degrees. What does a negative c value do? Well, according to this, if c is less than 0, you end up with a horizontal translation to the left, meaning that your whole wave function will be shifted to the left by 180 degrees. Lastly, our d value in this function is negative 3. And we are told that if d is negative, if it's less than 0, you end up with a vertical translation downwards, meaning that all the y-coordinates will be subtracted, in our case here, by negative 3. So let's write that down. You end up with a vertical transformation downwards. Now that we've covered number 1, let's move on to number 2. This time our function is negative 0.2 sine x minus 45 degrees plus 2. So now what we have here is an a value that is negative 0.2, and this tells us two things: a reflection across the x-axis, and it also tells us that you will end up with a wave that is vertically compressed, meaning that it will be shorter than the original sine x. So vertical compression. And to get your y-coordinates for this, you would have to take all of your y-coordinates and multiply them by 0.2, and that will tell you what the new y-coordinate will be. Next, we have our c-value, and that is, well, let's find out what our c-value is. In our case here, the c-value is positive 45. Now, you're probably confused because it looks like negative 45. But remember, this has to model that. So this would be x minus positive 45. This expression mean the exact same thing. So your c value is positive 45. This means that we will be shifting the whole wave to the right by 45 degrees. And that is defined right here. When c is greater than 0, you end up with a horizontal translation to the right. Horizontal translation to the right. And lastly, our d value is plus 2. And this tells us that we will end up experiencing a vertical translation. This time it's a vertical translation up by 2 units. So all the y-coordinates will be pushed up 2 units. So we have a vertical translation upwards. Now, of course, I've been using the words translation and transformation interchangeably. They mean the same thing in this case, okay? So don't get confused if I use one word over the other. And there you have it, two examples on how to describe transformations of a sinusoidal function.